Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ.
Why is it when you need a miracle, it doesn't happen, but when you least expect it, it happens?
You are married. You have challenges in your relationship, but your spouse is unwilling to accede to any counseling. Is divorce an option?
How does a parent handle a promiscuous child?
What are considered the do's and don'ts of a born-again couple who is not yet married?
There are always more questions than answers. So here is Apostle Gemma.
Grace and peace to you. I first want to thank God for bringing us all through 2023. And now we are graced with a new season in our lives, 2024. Father, we give you thanks for keeping us alive and well through 2023. And even those who are sick at this point, I speak your healing, your deliverance, your breakthrough, your miraculous power to work in and through us. For those who will have had a difficult and trying 2023, let this year be better. Cause each of us to leave the negatives in our past and help us to forge a new year where we will experience your greatness, we will experience your mercy. We'll experience your sovereign rule and reign over our lives, where breakthroughs and open doors and opportunities will be made available to us through your grace and your bounty. Father, bless each person logged on in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. And so we are so happy. Happy New Year to you. Happy 2024. May this year be one of your best, where we allow God to sovereignly rule and reign in our lives and in our affairs and watch him work for us. And as I prayed, 2023 may not have been your best, but this song says the best is yet to come. And that's how we have to live. We have to live with hope, and that is what keeps us alive, believing God, trusting God, knowing that as we put our lives into his hand, our best is yet to come. Would you believe this week that we celebrate 14 years of Ask Pastor Gemma? For 14 straight years, we didn't miss a week, starting in radio, and then we branched off to television, and God has kept us. And as I do all the time, I want to thank those of you who've kept with me over the years. Some people from the very inception, they've been loyal listeners and viewers of both the radio and TV programs. And I say thank you. I know you've been praying, and I want you to continue to pray for me, for us, for Vivian and myself and our family. And as I say family, let me start off by giving you some of the news and the latest things that are happening in our family. At this time, as we speak, we are in the midst of the Cracked Door Conference with our eldest child, Donnell Duncan, and his wife, Angel. As a matter of fact, we started on the 3rd, and
the final day would be the 5th at 6 p.m.
at Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. But if it's online and you can receive it, even if you are not present with us, but we'd love for you to come down and be a part of the Cracked Door Conference. Donnell also has launched a brand new book, The Knowledge of the Glory. We would have some copies, but we can't guarantee that we will have. You call the church 633-3780 and find out. If we do have copies, then you can come and purchase a copy in Diego Martin. But you can access the book at amazon.com, and you can get it in hard copy, you can get it ebook, in whatever version that you may need. The Knowledge of the Glory. But that's not the only big news that we have. In a couple days, we will be launching the long-awaited ministry called Bethel House of Worship with our second son, Dion, and his wife, Leah, in New Jersey. And if you want any information, you can access Dion at office at bhowng.com. Office at bhowng.com. Communicate with them that way, and they are going to give you all of the information that you will need. If you cannot attend in person, of course, it's going to be online, and that we will tell you how to get all that information when you call. You can call the church as well, Divine Destiny Worship Center, 633-3780, and whatever details that you may want, it will be forthcoming. In the event that you are a first-timer, my name is Gemma Duncan. I'm married to Apostle Vivian Duncan. And this year, we just about to enter into our 48th year of marriage. I mean, there's a lot for which we can thank God. There's a lot that we can celebrate and give God praise. Well, we have another child. We have a daughter. And you may be wondering, well, what about her? She's doing pretty good. Her name is Dr. Jade Patrice Duncan. And she heads the PK Connection. If you want to check her out, and that's a ministry for pastors, children, and grandchildren, thepkconnection.com, and you're going to get a lot more details. Let's talk about our normal, regular information that we would give you. As you know, we are located in Digo Martin, the headquarters, opposite Sodomex Drive on the Digo Martin main road in Trinidad. We have branches in Sangre Grande in Chaguanas. We have a branch in Faisabad, one in Tobago, and one on the island of Antigua. Our regular services, Sunday morning at 9 a.m., live and online in all of the branches. We have a teaching session online only called School of Intercession that is led by Apostle Vivian Duncan. And then we have our Friday service at 7 p.m., and that is online for now. Any changes, we're going to let you know what these changes are, because there most likely will be some changes in 2024. I've decided that to start the new year, I'm going to pause on the series that we were having for 2023, where we were talking about philosophy of life, that parents, the responsibility of parents to teach their children their philosophy of life, so that by the time the child leaves the home, that child already has a worldview that the parents want that child to have. And in our case, we're talking about parenting 101, the Bible way. So we are the ones, we are responsible for training up our children in the Bible. What's the worldview? What does the Bible have to say? What's the Bible's perspective? But for the next couple of weeks, I've decided that I will put that aside a little bit, because I want to share some excerpts from a message that our eldest son again, Apostle Donald Duncan, preached on the 17th of December, entitled Preparing for Our Day of Visitation. And that's absolutely important, simply because in 1986, our lives radically changed. And when I say our, I mean Vivian and I and our family. We went to bed that night, one night in January. And by the time we woke up the morning, Vivian, he woke me up to say that an angel visited him and gave him a message. And the message was a call for ministry, the call to the prophetic. And he said yes on both of our behalf and behalf of our family. Well, it's nearly 38 years since. And thankfully, the year still holds, and here we are, having been to many countries that we never dreamed of going with the same gospel. And both of us are now working together and sometimes separately with the message of Jesus Christ. And in that early years, the Holy Spirit said to us that Trinidad and the Caribbean will become a beacon for the gospel, and people would leave all over the world to visit Trinidad and Tobago and the Caribbean islands because of the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And here in 2024, our son is given this message, preparing for a day of visitation. And so I thought that that was absolutely important, that Holy Spirit will now give the next generation a similar message. And that's why I felt I wanted to share this message with you.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for your word. We thank you, Lord, for being here with us today. We thank you for your Holy Spirit, that indeed this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you, Lord, for a word in season for those who are weary. Right now, we pray that you open our minds to understand the scriptures. Open our eyes to see in the spirit. Give us the ears of the learned. Give us the tongue of the learned. Give us the mind of Christ. Lead us and guide us through this time of study of your scriptures. Give us quick understanding. We pray, God, that each person here would know what you want us to know and hear what you want us to hear. Even right now, Lord, we pray that your Holy Ghost moves in this place in a special way. The spirit of wisdom and revelation and knowledge of you, spirit of understanding and supernatural intelligence, the spirit of knowledge and awareness, the spirit of counsel and insight, the spirit of might and strength, the spirit of the reverential fear of the Lord, the spirit of the obedient fear of the Lord, the sevenfold Holy Ghost. We invite you, Holy Ghost, to move in each of our lives in a special way, that each person would know that the Lord is on our side, that the Lord is with us. And we pray that we would hear your voice clearly today. Let there be no confusion. Let there be clarity among us, God, as we speak into our hearts what it is that you want to say to us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. So I thought about what I wanted to talk about today and what is it that the Lord wants to say to us. And we're going into a very special, I guess, end of year schedule where things are going to be, there's a lot of things that are going to be happening. And as a result, we are not going to continue our end time series until January. So today is the last Sunday where we are teaching here in person like this. And I thought about what am I going to say as we transition into the special end of year series of events. And the Lord was like, well, let's talk about 2024. Vision for 2024, preparing for our day of visitation. He's like, we need to get ready for our day of visitation. The day of visitation, the whole concept of it. Let's take a look at 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 12, just to get our own understanding of what do we mean by the day of visitation. 1 Peter 2, 12 in the Amplified. Let's read that together after 3. 2:3. Keep your behavior excellent among the unsaved Gentiles. Conduct yourself honorably with graciousness and integrity, so that, or whatever reason they may slander you as evildoers, yet by observing your good deeds, they may instead come to glorify God in the day of visitation, when he looks upon them with mercy. So there is this concept in the scripture of a day of visitation where God shows up and he does something special on that day. It's a day that people look forward to, some with great anticipation, some with great dread. But regardless, it's a day when God acts, a day of God's a day of reckoning that the Lord intends to engage us in. So what is a time of visitation or a day of visitation? It comes from the Greek word episkope. The Greek word episkope. And it's a day of investigation, a day of inspection. a very important day, a day of investigation, a day of inspection, and as they said, the day of visitation. It's that act by which God looks into and searches out the ways, deeds, character of men in order to judge them, their lot, accordingly, whether joyous or sad. So there is a time, a day, a moment that always happens when God decides, all right, I am going to show up to investigate what's been happening. I am showing up for inspection. So I have never served in the military, and I never will, but I have seen on television that there are those moments when there is inspection time. And Elder Danley, who led the military in Trinidad, knows about that way better than me. Where there's inspection time, when they come to inspect, whether they inspect the clothing, the shoes, and the outfit of the soldiers, their uniforms, they inspect the barracks, they inspect the rooms, whatever they're inspecting, there's that moment. And God has those inspection moments where he is going to inspect, where he's going to investigate, where he's going to visit, when he's going to look and search out people's ways, people's deeds, people's character, in order to judge them their lot accordingly, whether joyous or sad. So a day of visitation or time of visitation is a time of judgment where God does great things for people, and he also does, he judges. And if the lot is something great, you'll get something great. If it's not something great, you know, if you didn't do a good job, you're not going to get rewarded. There's going to be a just response from God. So that's the first thing. So I'm just going to kind of talk about that a little bit, because one thing God has been telling us is, you know, I want you to get ready for me to show up. And when God has his days of visitation, his days, his moments, sometimes it could feel like a surprise. But the truth is, God is intentional to give us a heads up. And that's what he's doing with us right now. He's saying, look, I want you to get ready for your moment. You're going to have your moment. And I want to make sure that when I show up, you know that I'm showing up. And I'm telling you ahead of time, I want you to get ready. And everybody's going to have their own story of visitation from the Lord in this season, where he's going to show up in his own way to hold us accountable, to speak into our lives, to reward us, etc. So Jerusalem missed their day of visitation. Jerusalem missed their moment. Jerusalem missed their time. And it really impacted Jesus when he realized that they were missing their moment. Luke 19, verses 41 to 44 in the New King James Version. Luke 19, verses 41 to 44 in the New King James Version. Now as he drew near, he saw the city and wept over it, saying, if you had known, even you, especially in this your day, the things that make for your peace, but now they are hidden from your eyes. For days will come upon you when your enemies will build an embankment around you, surround you, and close you in on every side, and level you and your children within you to the ground, and they will not leave in you one stone upon another, because you did not know the time of your visitation. You know, the funny thing is, if you read the scripture, one of the first things you notice is there were few times in the scripture when Jesus wept. We know the scripture that says Jesus wept because that's the shortest verse in the Bible. And it deals with Lazarus having died and his sisters being in mourning. But here is another example of Jesus weeping. He wept over Jerusalem because they missed their moment. Jesus came as an answer to their prayer, as a fulfillment of every prophetic word that they had received concerning their Messiah. He came as the promise that had been given to them for generations. And when he showed up, they did not recognize him or value him or treat him with the honor that they should have. He was the answer. And this was their moment. Of course, they didn't understand because they were oppressed by the Romans. And the only moment they wanted was a moment of physical freedom or a moment of vengeance against the Romans. And Jesus didn't come to physically free them or give them vengeance from the Romans. He came to free them spiritually. He came to give them an answer for their eternal salvation, something which they had no interest in at the time or understanding of. And he was like, man, you missed it. And all I could hear the Lord saying is, our moment is upon us. Our moment of Holy Ghost visitation is upon us. Our moment of manifestation of prophecies is upon us. Our moment of God finally doing what he's been promising for generations to us is upon us. And what he doesn't want to happen is we miss our moment and then he has to weep over us like he wept over Jerusalem. Where he's like, man, y'all been praying for this. Y'all been wanting this so bad. You get it and you did not take advantage of it. You totally missed it. He's like, I can't have that. That can't happen. Not with you. And all he says is, tell my people, don't miss their moment. Because it's upon us. Don't miss your moment. Don't miss your moment. Jesus wept over the people of Jerusalem because they missed their time of visitation. They spent generations looking forward to the arrival of their Messiah and did not recognize him when he showed up. So instead of salvation and blessings because of the arrival of Jesus, they experienced devastation and destruction a few years after he left. So AD 70, one generation after Jesus left, the Romans destroyed Jerusalem, destroyed the temple, broke down the walls, mashed up the place, just like he prophesied. Now the truth is, he came ahead of that, a generation before, with salvation, with hope, with freedom, and they rejected him. And judgment came right after. So the day of visitation has two sides. It has rewards, it has rescue, it has salvation, but also has judgment and devastation and destruction. Those who are ready, those who are rightly positioned, can look forward with excitement to the day of visitation. And those who are not ready will look forward with dread.
Then Moses said, please show me your glory. Exodus chapter 33 verse 18 in the Amplified Bible. In the spring of 2022, after 2 years of the COVID-19 pandemic, God said that it was time for his church to begin preparing for the next great awakening. He said that what was coming next was a manifestation of his glory on a level that our generation had never seen before. While we have no quantitative means to prove the full extent of this, we believe that many Christians across the globe have also been looking forward to this unprecedented outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Some call it revival fire, while others call it a sovereign move of God. Some call it a shift in the Spirit, or any other number of titles. Nevertheless, we're all in some way or another referring to the same thing. God's presence will be manifested on the earth in such a remarkable fashion that it will forever change the trajectory of the Church of Jesus Christ first, and then the world. This book, Knowledge of the Glory, Preparing for the Next Great Awakening by author Donald Duncan, is a prophetic message from God to help his church prepare for it. Available in paperback, hardcover, and ebook formats. Pick up your copy today at Amazon.com or any major online bookseller.
To forget what Jesus said. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. Please join me next week for part two of Preparing for Day of Visitation, excerpts from the sermon from Apostle Donald Duncan.
The final day would be the 5th at 6 p.m.